Hey guys, this is Cole from Autel Robotics. In our last video, we discussed the general camera settings in the Autel Explorer app, like ISO, shutter speed, and white balance. Today, we're gonna dive a little bit deeper by going into the advanced camera settings. Hopefully by the end of this video, you will be able to manipulate your settings for the best image in an ever-changing environment. Welcome to the flight deck. We're gonna start off by powering up your controller and connecting to your mobile device. If you are indoors and do not plan on flying, be sure to remove your propellers before powering on the aircraft. Once you've powered on and connected the aircraft, you're gonna wanna open up the Autel Explorer app. Once in the camera view, press the arrow in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen to open up the camera settings. Press the camera icon in the bottom right-hand corner to open up the advanced camera settings. We'll look at our settings from top to bottom, starting with Grid. Grid is an overlay to assist you in composing your shot. As you can see here, you'll have two different grid options to choose from. Moving on from Grid, we have Center Point. Center Point is another overlay that allows you to center subjects in your shot. As you can see here, you have a variety of different icon options to choose from. Next up, we have Manual Focus Assist. This allows you to see what subjects are in focus and out of focus in your shot. You will see a red overlay in your image for anything that is in focus. After the Focus Assist, we have the Histogram. The Histogram allows you to see different light levels in your shot and understand if any part of your image is underexposed or overexposed. You're also able to tap and drag the histogram to reposition it anywhere on your screen. Next up, we have Gimbal Lock. Gimbal Lock allows you to hold your gimbal at a specific pitch angle and is useful in still photography. After Gimbal Lock, we have the Defog function. Defog allows you to account for a variety of atmospheric challenges, such as fog, haze, dust, or smoke. It also extends visibility and improves sharpness, contrast, and saturation. Next up, we have a unique feature called ROI, which stands for Region of Interest. This feature allows you to prioritize quality in a specific part of your image when transmission is weak. Once ROI has been enabled, you're able to select a certain part of the image for improved clarity. ROI is adjusted on a scale of 1 to 10. 1 being the weakest and 10 being the strongest. After ROI, we have overexposure warning. This allows you to see overexposed parts of your image displayed by zebra stripes. Settings like ISO, exposure value, or shutter speed can be used to reduce overexposure in your shot. Moving on from overexposure warning, we have ASS or subtitle files. The ASS files are an easy encoding format for adding subtitles. Moving on, we have video encoding format. The Evo 2 offers two options, H.264 and H.265. H.265 is the preferred encoding format for anything above HD resolution. H.265 allows for better image quality and compression. It also gives the user access to 10-bit color, just like HDR. One thing to note is that you may have trouble playing back or editing H.265 footage on older devices. Next, we have anti-flicker. Anti-flicker is a tool that can be used to remove artificial light flicker from your shot. This feature can be used when filming electrical frequencies that are foreign to the frame rate that you are recording in. The 60 Hz setting is most often used in North America, while the 50 Hz setting is most commonly used in other countries. After anti-flicker, we have reset camera. This allows you to reset your camera settings to factory standard. Next up, we have the ability to format both the SD card and flash card, also known as internal memory. I recommend using the internal storage as a backup. There are only 8 GB of storage available on this flash card. Regardless, always be sure to save your data before formatting either card. To get the data off of your internal card, you will need to connect a USB-C cable from your drone to your computer. In the event that you plan on using an SD card other than the one that came with your Evo 2, make sure that it meets or exceeds the V30 standard write speed for microSD cards. If they are below that V30 rating, you will run into low write speed warnings. that will prevent you from recording your footage. And that concludes our camera settings tutorials for the Autel Evo 2 series. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment any questions below.